I say to you today, my friends, that even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream.
It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream.
I have a dream
that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed.
We hold these truths to be self-evident,
that all men are created equal.
I have a dream that one day on the Red Hills of Georgia,
the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together
at the table of brotherhood.
I have a dream
that one day even the state of Mississippi
and state sweltering with the heat of injustice,
sweltering with the heat of oppression,
we will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice.
I have a dream that my four little children
will one day live in a nation
where they will not be judged by the color of their skin,
but by the content of their character.
I have a dream today.
I have a dream today.
I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day
little black boys and black girls
will be able to join hands
with little white boys and little white girls and be sisters and brothers.
I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day
every valley shall be exalted,
and every hill and mountain shall be made low.
The rough places will be made plain,
and the crooked places will be made straight.
And the glory of the Lord shall be revealed,
and all flesh shall see it together.
This is our hope. This is the faith I go back to the South with.
With this faith, we will be able to hew out of the mountains of the spear
a stone of hope.
With this faith, we will be able to transform
the jangling discords of our nation
into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood.
Into a beautiful symphony of brotherhood.
With this faith, we will be able to work together,
to pray together,
to struggle together,
to go to jail together,
to stand up for freedom together,
to stand up for freedom together. Knowing that we will be free one day.
Knowing that we will be free one day.
This will be the day.
This will be the day when all of God's children
will be able to sing with new meaning.
My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, in thee I sing.
Land where my father died.
Land of the pilgrim's pride.
From every mountainside, let freedom ring.
And if America is to be a great nation,
this must come true.
So let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire.
Let freedom ring
from the mighty mountains of New York.
Let freedom ring
from the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania.
Let freedom ring
from the snow-capped
Rockies of Colorado.
Let freedom ring from the curvaceous slopes of California.
But not only that.
Let freedom ring
from Stone Mountain of Georgia.
Let freedom ring from Lookout Mountain of Tennessee.
Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill of Mississippi.
From every mountainside.
Let freedom ring.
From every mountainside.
Let freedom ring.
And when this happens?
When we allow freedom to ring.
When we let it ring to every village and every hamlet.
From every state to every city.
We will be able to speed up that day.
When all of God's children, black men and white men,
Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics,
will be able to join hands
and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, "Free at last, free at last. Thank God Almighty we are free at last."
I have a dream.
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 I have a dream.